I'll be preaching in the 8 o'clock service Sunday at Evangel Church, Stansbury at Grand River on the west side of Detroit. And I trust that the Lord will bless the broadcast tonight in a way that you can feel his presence, even as I feel his presence now. Pastor Vogel speaking.
Yes, hi, Pastor Vogel. This is Pam. Yeah, I wanted to call in and thank you for praying for me. I went to the doctor today.
Yes.
They said it was all good report. They couldn't find nothing wrong with me.
Hallelujah.
Oh, and what you mentioned earlier about being abused.
Yes.
Pray for me that the Lord would deliver me, because I had been abused when I was a child sexually.
Yes.
I was abused by my grandfather and by certain people, certain members of my family when I was a child. And I keep having nightmares of this, you know, that the Lord would deliver me from this.
We're going to pray, Pam. God bless you for the good report testimony. And we're going to ask for God's favor in what you bring to us now. Have a good night. Dear Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask that you would bless, dear God, a people to have what Pam has received, a good report. In the name of Jesus, dear God, grant a good report, I pray. I ask, God, that you would continue to bless Pam physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually. And dear God, for all the baggage that is still in her thoughts because of the past, dear God, I ask that she would be able to be strong and to be quickened and able, dear God, to be blessed, to be able to go forward and not in any way be dragged down by what has happened that can't be altered today. But thank God that sin, not only that we've committed, but sin that has come against us can be gone. And God set us free from the sin that has come against us as well as the sins that we've committed. Help us, dear God, to be loose from the power of sin in whatever way it comes into our moment. Dear God, I do pray. Bless exceedingly, and I thank you, Lord. I claim it in Jesus' name, your blessing in this hour. In Jesus' name, amen. I want all of you to feel free to call tonight. Phone number is 1-248-601-2600. But I also have a heart that focuses so definitely on the silent majority. And all of you that will not be calling, my prayer is that you will feel something during the broadcast that you don't feel any other time for some of you. I would that you would feel it more often, but may the Holy Spirit move upon you as you listen to this ministry. May it touch your situation. May it touch your surroundings. May it touch your mind, your body, all that you are. The gospel is the power of God, and we thank you, Lord. Pastor Vogel speaking.
Hi, I went to the doctor today because my side was hurting, my left side, and they just took x-rays, and they said if it keeps on hurting me, come back, and they're going to test it for me.
And so they'll come back and you'll go back and find out what those x-rays revealed?
Well, they're sending them out to the special rest.
Well, we'll pray for full recovery. Dear Father, be with all of us today. And dear God, I ask that we could know by faith that I will not die but live and give God the glory. I will not die but live and give God the glory. I will not die but live and give God the glory. And may this daughter have a confirming word that comes that things aren't as severe as they could be, that your power is available going forward is my plea. Grant it, Lord, we ask it in the name of Jesus, and we rejoice and we praise you, Lord. We claim it in Jesus' name. Amen. Pastor Vogel speaking.
Hi, Pastor Vogel. How are you?
well?
Good. I need prayer for my daughter. Her name is Christine. She applied for a job, and she really needs a job really, really bad. I need prayer that this job will come through for her.
What age is Christy?
Well, she's 19.
Just a young girl?
Yeah, she's just running around with a lot of different people. Young people, you know, not looking for a job. She graduated from high school, but she hasn't been looking for a job. And she has a son. He's 3 years old, and she needs somebody to take care of him.
And we're going to pray that her life will go in the right direction.
Yeah, also I need prayer for my life as well, go in the right direction, because deliver me. I need to be delivered from destructive relationships. This relationship that I've been in is not good for me. God knows what it's about, and it needs to be severed.
I'm going to pray with all my heart. God bless you and Christy.
Thank you.
Dear Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask that we could get out of the wrong path. Dear God, I pray. And getting out of the path that we're already in isn't that simple, but it needs to be done. And I ask God that this mother could get off of the wrong path in the name of Jesus, that you would help her, dear God, to seek first the kingdom of God and your righteousness. And you promise that all the things that are precious will be added unto us. I ask, God, that you would be with Christy, a daughter with a son, that you would minister to this one 19 years of age. I ask, God, in the name of Jesus, that the devil would be defeated. I ask, God, in the name of Jesus, that she would feel like a mother, that she would act like a mother, that she would function like a mother, that she would be delivered, dear God, from the power of a double-minded attitude, that she would be able, dear God, to be blessed and minister to her in this hour, meeting all of her need is my prayer. I ask, God, that you would help her to be able, dear God, to have her needs met concerning the economic moment, concerning the relationships, concerning all that is a part of ongoing living, I pray. Grant it, Lord, we ask it in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name.
It seems like you went out, went blank there for a little bit.
Yeah, right. We lost our...
Oh, I got you on the phone. I'll do a prayer request, too. My name's Jason. I called you a couple weeks ago. Wife, five kids, has a drug problem. Probably remember me. I don't know.
Amen.
You there?
I'm listening, yes.
Well, things are a little rough, but they are getting better. And I went and bought a book and to help me with this, and I have to recommend it. I'm on day 11. I don't know if you heard of it. It's called A Love There.
Okay.
That's from the out of the movie, but I was kind of skeptical. I bought it, and I'm 11 days into this book, and I've accomplished more in 11 days than I probably have in 11 years. And she seems to be responding pretty well, and I just realized that she has her problems, but she I've also had mine too, and I've been working on those, and it's only made things better between the both of us, and we've gotten along pretty well, and she's still very ill, though. She was having some kidney problems as far as an infection, and she's almost done with that, and she's very eager to get into detox and get off the prescription drugs, and so all I pray, ask for you to pray for tonight is pray to keep her strong, get her well, get my wife well soon.
Amen.
And just pray that they keep strong with this book, because every day it's kind of a struggle. When she's, you know, I come in and she might just, you know, kind of verbally attack me when I come home from work, whatever, and I just bite my tongue and respond with kindness instead of anger.
Beautiful.
I've noticed that I've gotten the same back once I've did that, so no matter how mean she can be to me, I just respond in love and kindness, and it's had profound effects, and this book just is amazing, and, but, you know, I'm not even halfway up the hill yet, so I just pray to keep me strong and make me a better man And I realized that the only way to change her is to change myself first.